Hello everyone and welcome to Little Things Chunky. That's me. And I think this video I'll just give another brief update into what I've been doing on the Trumpeter T-64, 1981 model. I'll talk briefly about what I've done, what are the paints I've used so far and the processes, and then maybe at the end of the video I'll show what else is on the go. I can't discipline myself just to do one thing and then see that from start through to completion and then start something else. I don't know, I flip from one thing to another, and there are several things on the go pretty much always. So I'll show you something later that I'm working on. But first of all, the Trumpeter T-64. So what have I been doing this week? I started by attaching the commander's station, if you like, the hatch and the machine gun. This was so that I could fit the commander in there firmly, have a firm location for him to slot into, so that I could then modify his backside. And what I did was just cut the plastic away, carve some plastic away, replaced it with black milliput, any epoxy putty would do, and just placed him back in there so that he now seats firmly onto the hatch ring, and hopefully I've got a bit of clean up to do yet, but hopefully he looks far more natural than he did before. And of course I put the attached all this, and within a minute I snapped off the muzzle. I usually wait an hour or two before I break things off, but I've beaten my record. I've got down to about a minute. I wonder if I can do better next time. So I've also just started sort of colouring in parts of the vehicle. So the spare track links here, the covers for the smoke grenade discharges, the end cap of this end of the snorkel has been done, but although not that one, and not yet the gun the mantlet, not yet the mantlet cover. But I'm sort of just starting to colour things in at this stage. I'm also doing the same for the hull, of course. Sort of working from the back to the front. So, for example, these little things here, which I presume on the real vehicle, are little rubber fences that prevent dirty air, being drawn up and sucked into what I imagine is the air intake, although. If someone wants to correct me, please do. These are moulded on the Trumpeter kit as soft vinyl, rubbery vinyl. So I don't know if that means that's kind of what they are on the real thing. But I've interpreted as being, well, they'll be rubber. So I've painted them as rubber with green paint flaking off. And I just started to sort of colour in bits and pieces around the back. So the spare track links are sort of coloured in a rusty colour. The mud flaps are a grey colour, and this is all ready for any further weathering I may want to do. I think the rear of the vehicle needs to be dusty. They always seem to, you know, dust attracts itself to the rear of a vehicle like this. So I think there needs to be some sort of light dust residue on it. And here's a little thing maybe someone can tell me about. Now, I'm assuming these little markers are just tail lights, and I believe, and I've painted those just red, by the way, those little dots in the middle. I believe this thing in the middle here is the convoy light. There's no bulb or anything molded onto this kit, but I imagine that's the convoy light. I did see a photograph online of the rear of a T-64, and that certainly does look like a convoy light housing. But there's also something on the rear of the turret, which I don't know, which I can't identify. And that's, there's another little lamp just there. So I'm guessing this is some kind of white light searchlight, and that is a marker of some sort. And because it's facing rearwards, I've painted it red. I don't know if it's supposed to be any other colour, but if somebody knows what that tiny little thing should be, and it's something other than red, please do let me know, so I'd like to correct it. A word on the decals for Trumpeter. I think they're outstanding. They're really, really good. They are so thin, And strong as well. They're not sort of thin. You dip them in water and they start folding up on themselves or whatever. They're pretty robust decals. And with just a little bit of setting agent, they suck down straight into the surface. And I know this is a flat surface, but with a thin coat of varnish over the top, and there's no evidence at all of there being a carrier film around them or anything like that. They're really, really good decals. I'm very impressed with Trumpeter decals. Little communist symbol on the other side too. So that's what I've done. Maybe I should now sort of explain how I've done it. The base green was made with a mix of mission models, three Russian greens, sort of mix, approximately a third of each one, until I found a green that I was comfortable, that I was happy with. I know Soviet vehicles, well, in fact, any vehicle, it varies quite a lot from vehicle to vehicle, from age to age. I just sort of mixed one a green that I thought was approximately correct, and applied it with that mission models paint. And then what I've done is sort of just worn the paint, so it's sort of a mottled, sort of lighter in some areas, darker in others, a little bit sort of like a little bit grubby, a little bit sort of ingrained dirt, a little bit polished or whatever. So I don't know if that's visible. Hopefully that's visible in this shot. You can sort of see hopefully some variation in greens and browns around, a sort of mottly effect. And the idea here is not to make a dirty tank, but just to have a paint layer that is fatigued and discoloured. And how I've done that is by using probably an unlikely set of paints, which are Citadel paints. So I've used Citadel acrylics, and I've used Citadel contrast paints, which are essentially just inks with other ingredients in, very, very thin paints of different colours. So greens and sort of greeny browns and dirty browns and very sort of dark browns. And I've applied these in a thinned them down and applied them to the vehicle, and tried sort of pre-wetted vehicle. So I'd taken the vehicle and I've spritzed it with water. You could use an airbrush, I guess, if you wish, but just spritz over it. So you've got a nice wet surface, and then just lay down thinned paint in little places, in little spots. And this kind of the wet base of the vehicle allows the water to the thin paint to spread out and dry slowly, so you don't get the coffee stain marks if you were to do it otherwise. And I used different tones of green, different tones of brown, splashed it all over, and kind of see what the result is. It's pleasing to my eye. So now is the time to start doing the actual sort of weathering. So now is where the dirt and any other kind of damages may come into it. Although I'm trying not to do this one. I don't want a dirt laden tank. I don't want one that's got chips all over it. It's just a used and dirty tank. I do think actually that the way I've painted the left hand fuel barrel is slightly fanciful. I wanted to give some variety, some variation to greens, and this is meant to represent a dirtier, maybe a previously used fuel barrel, once been taken from another vehicle, has been maybe left around for ages. I think the weathering is a little fanciful, but I think I'll leave it as it is. Life's too short. What else have I been doing? Well, I've been painting the log, the unditching log that sits along the back of the vehicle. So this is just brown with a couple of sort of dark washes into it, and the lighter brown for the sawn ends, and that will be attached to the rear of the vehicle in due course. So that's really about it for the T-64. That's as far as I've got. Loving every moment of it. Still enjoying this kit enormously. Still enjoying the painting process. I don't normally work methodically at all. I'm just not disciplined enough to be methodical. I usually, my work is done haphazardly. But I'm trying to, at least for this vehicle, sort of do the best I can and sort of have some kind of process that I stick to. And so far it's working, and so far I'm enjoying it. So I think really all that's left is to go over the vehicle and do the wear and the tear and maybe some evidence of dirt or dust that might be in a few places, paint the figures, and then either call it a day or think about putting it on a base with some kind of context for the waving crewman. So that's a T-64. What else have I got going? Well, one of the things is this fellow, which was a gift from Mrs. Junkie some time ago, either Christmas or birthday, I can't quite remember yet. I haven't done a lot of it yet. But it's coming together. The swing arm and the frame have been painted in aluminium. This was over a gloss black acrylic primer. I'm not sure whether it was Vallejo gloss primer or Steinerres gloss primer. Can't recall now. But then Alclad aluminium was put over the top. Really pleased with how that's come out. Lots more detail painting to be done, and some decals to be applied to these. So that's about where I am with the Suzuki. You've seen where I am with the T-64. Who knows? Maybe next video I'll have lost interest in one or both of those things and be doing something else instead. But anyway, thanks for watching. It's good to be able to share. I enjoy sharing what I'm doing. Hopefully you enjoy seeing what other people are doing. If you do, let me know. If you don't, let me know so I can change what I'm doing. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you again soon.